Gaspar Yanga, often simply Yanga or Nyanga, was the leader of a slave rebellion in Mexico during the early period of Spanish colonial rule, said to be of the Bran people and a member of the royal family of Gabon or Gabon. Yanga came to be the head of a band revolting slaves near Veracruz around 1570. Escaping to the difficult terrain of the highlands, he and his people built a small Maroon colony or palenque. For more than 30 years, it grew, partially surviving by capturing caravans, bringing goods to Veracruz. However, in 1609, the Spanish colonial government decided to undertake a campaign itself to regain control of the territory, and failed. Gaspar Yanga is attributed with, and quite possibly very truly, the first Afro-Hebrew captive to gain his liberty. Him being brought over from Ethiopia, from Africa, across the Ethiopic Ocean, in pretty sure working a plantation within the Mexican state of Veracruz, eventually, you know, escaped and sought freedom in the highlands, in the mountains. And so, you know, with time, he kind of, like, I'm pretty sure, met up with some other escapees, and to the point where they had built some kind of, it says here, a small Maroon colony. Now, Maroon or Maroon, we'll wait for this to load up. Okay, so it says here, Maroons, from the Latin American Spanish word cimarrón, feral animal, fugitive runaway, literally living on mountaintops, from the Spanish word cima, top, summit, were African refugees that escaped slavery in the West Indies, Central America, South America, and North America, who formed independent settlements. The term can also be applied to their descendants, and the same designation has also become a derivative of the word to maroon. All right, so eventually Gaspar Yanga, you know, they built up a force, and the way in which they survived was kind of like attacking, you know, Spanish caravans. And so eventually it became a problem for the Spanish colonial powers, even the fact that these facts, you know, the news spread abroad, and so slaves, you know, mustered up the courage to escape, knowing there was a place for them. And so eventually the Spanish colonial powers, they arm up, they accumulate some kind of force to attack Gaspar Yanga and his crew. You know, long story short, they weren't able to be successful in their campaign, and so this results in a compromise, and officially, before the eyes of the colonial powers that were established in that time in the country of Mexico, Gaspar Yanga was the first Afro-Hebrew captive to be entitled with liberty, and not only that, but gained was entitled to the property or terrain which he controlled and ruled. That province to this very day exists, and it is in fact a part of Veracruz, Mexico. It is Yanga Veracruz, and still to this very day, the majority of the population, or a large, very large part of the population inhabiting the areas surrounding Yanga Veracruz are in fact Afro-Mexican or of that descendancy. And so we could say in Gaspar Yanga, a Afro-Hebrew hero established in Mexico. And so, you know, very few Mexicans even know about this. We're pretty sure very few Afro-Hebrews know about this, and so thus, you know, necessary to bring this forth, Gaspar Yanga, you know, the first Afro-Hebrew captive to gain liberty, and not only that, but establish the first wholly free province, city-state, we could say, in all the Americas, for 400 years, give or take a few years. In Veracruz, the city of Yanga has been officially a province of liberty. And so that's pretty interesting in itself. So, Gaspar Yanga, the untold story.